Hi there, this is René for Network Lessons. In this video, I'll show you why we use summarization. And I'll do this by using these two routers. So we've got R1 and R2. And behind R1, we have four loopback interfaces. Now, I will advertise these in a routing protocol. I'll be using RIP. And then I'll show you the difference between using summarization or not. So let me show you the console of these routers. So you can see we got these four loopback interfaces here. And I already configured RIP. So what we have is this. Using version 2, auto summarization is disabled. And I'm using these two network commands, so that RIP is enabled and that it's advertising all loopback interfaces. So when we go to R2, RIP is also configured, but only on its Ethernet interface. So when we take a look at the routing table here, we can see that R2 has learned these four networks. And what we'll do is I'll enable a debug here so that we can see what is going on. So RIP will send these updates every now and then, every 30 seconds by default. So let's wait till we see something. There we go. So we can see that R2 has received a RIP update, version 2 update, and it's about these four networks from the loopback interface. Now let me show you what happens when I shut one of these interfaces on R1. So let's say that we're going to the loopback 0 interface and I do a shutdown command. Then over here, we see this triggered update. So R1 is advertising that this network over here, so this is the network on loopback 0, is inaccessible. So this is a triggered update. So when an interface on R1 is going down, then R1 will send a triggered update. And it will do this for all these four loopback interfaces. Now, let me do a no-shut on this loopback. And what I'll do is I'll create a summary route on R1. And then I'll show you the difference when I shut one of the loopback interfaces. So what we have to do is go to the interface. And I'll create a summary route. And I'll create this summary route. So 172.16 with this subnet mask. So this will be a slash 16. So basically R1 is now advertising this entire range. So R2 will think that everything that starts with 172.16 is behind R1. So let's advertise that summary route. And we can see some stuff over here on R2. So you can see that it has received this summary route. So right now what we see is the summary route over here. But we are also still seeing these specific networks. Now these will disappear after a while because R1 is not advertising these anymore. And what I can do is I can do a clear IP route to speed things up a bit. So when I do another show IP route RIP, I only see this summary entry now. Okay, so let's see what happens when I shut the loopback on R1. So remember, when I did this without summary route, then R1 would send a triggered update. But now when I shut it, you can see that nothing is happening here. So R1 is losing an interface, but this does not impact the summary route. So nothing is changing here. So this is one advantage of summarization. It's routing stability. Now let me show you what happens when I shut some of the other interfaces. So let's shut loopback 1 and 2. And you can see nothing is going on here. So I can lose 3 interfaces and we are still doing good. So 3 of these interfaces are down. Now once I shut the last loopback interface, so this is the last interface that has an IP address within the summary range. So let's clean up the console of R2 a bit. Shut the interface. And now you can see that R2 is receiving an update. Because R1 doesn't have any interface anymore that is active in this range, you can see that R1 is sending a triggered update where it says that the summary route is now inaccessible. And of course it will be gone. So that's one advantage of summarization. And of course the other advantage is that we have smaller routing tables. So with summarization I only have one entry that covers all the loopback interfaces. And without summarization I will have 4 entries, which of course requires a bit more memory. Okay, so if we have one summary route or 4 specific entries, this doesn't matter much. But if we look on the at the internet, where we use BGP, then we have about 300,000 or 400,000 entries, and these are all summarized routes. So without summarization, you will need very large routing tables, and you will need a lot of memory in your routers. So let me also show you a disadvantage of summarization, and let's just do a no shut on all of these. So now you can see R2 has the summary route again. Now R2 thinks that it can reach everything within this range by going to R1. So if I send something, let's ping 172.16.5.5, which R1 doesn't have, then you can see that R2 does send this traffic to R1. You can see the U here, which means unreachable. So R1 is responding and telling R2 that this network is unreachable. But R2 is sending it to R1 because it believes that R1 has it. So normally with summarization, something to keep in mind is, for example, you have to think about your summary route. So right now I'm using this summary route, but I only have these 4 networks. So you should try and use to create very specific summary routes. So to give you a quick example, it would be better to create a summary route that only covers these 4 networks. So that would be, this should be it. So 255, 255, 252 will cover only these 4 networks. So when we take a look here at R2, we can see the old summary route. This will disappear in a bit. And we have the new summary route. So the old summary route is gone. We only have this entry. So now I can ping. I can still ping all of these. But I can't ping anything that falls out of the summary range because R2 doesn't have a route for it. So make sure that you use specific summary routes. Okay, that's it. So this is all that I wanted to show you. I hope this has been useful. Thanks for watching and till next time.